watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend. Good evening. Welcome to Now It's Dark on Amter TV. I'm your host, Hank Miller, and we're watching Night Tide from 1961 from director Curtis Harrington. Thanks for tuning in tonight, J-Mo Session. Glad to see you back again this week, Rocky. Thanks for showing up, Lith 13. Hope we'll have a good night tonight. Sure, y'all recognize right in here. This is the great Dennis Hopper. The film stars Dennis Hopper and Linda Lawson. Thanks for tuning in, Mark. This film was all shot in Santa Monica and Venice, California, right there on the beautiful Pacific Ocean. Southern California. Let's watch the opening scene. Thank you. cool jazz. It's an interactive show. You can always do a chat in the Twitch window. You can always call and speak to Hank live. Jazz, yeah. That is Linda Lawson. Play the character Mora.
Excuse me, do you mind if I sit here? I can't see anything but their backs from where I'm sitting.
It's all right.
It's really a great combo, huh?
I'd like to listen, please.
Cold.
That's real fine music, isn't it?
Yes, I like it.
You mind if I buy you a drink?
No, thank you.
I'd like to.
Could be a PBR table session. This actress here, her name is Marjorie Cameron. I'll talk about her in a minute.
Si demain, ta Paris, mais tous des cousus, agapu. On est pour y cinéma. Pas une anditumé, ça n'a.
Who is that woman?
I don't know.
Well, what did she say to you?
Nothing. Would you pay my check for me, please? Thank you.
Hey, wait a minute.
Didn't sound like French to me. Doug, thanks for calling in. I mean, thanks for watching tonight, Doug. Again, we're watching Night Tide from 1961, directed by Curtis Harrington. And starring the incredible Dennis Hopper.
Hi.
Why are you following me?
Well, you left so fast, I don't know how to reach you or anything. Like, I'd like to see you again if it's okay.
It's impossible.
Hey, wait. Just let me talk to you for a little while. I'll just walk along with you. Shouldn't be out alone on a night like this anyway.
Would I be safe with you?
Yes. Hey, I know that woman upset you. I thought maybe you'd need somebody to talk to. Come on, is this the way? Okay?
He's just eager, I think. Gabriel
says. Here's where I live.
It's a merry-go-round.
Mm-hmm.
Do you live inside a wooden horse?
No. My apartment is upstairs.
If you've ever been to the Santa Monica Pier, this merry-go-round still exists.
Sometimes.
Just check it out.
But I love the music. It reminds me of when...
Of when you were a kid?
Yes. Well, good night.
Wait a minute. I don't even know your name. My name's Johnny.
I am called Maura.
Aren't you going to invite me upstairs for a while?
I have to go in.
Just for a while.
Good night, Johnny.
Hey, Maura?
Yeah, that's quite a line. Just for a while.
Can I see you tomorrow? Please?
All right. I'll fix breakfast for you.
Okay, what time?
Around 11.
Okay, I'll be here at 11.
Good night.
Night.
And of course, Dennis Hopper, great actor, also a fantastic filmmaker. He made one of America's greatest films, Easy Rider. Also an amazing artist and photographer.
Good morning.
Good morning. You opening up the merry-go-round already?
Sure am. Sunday's our big day.
Those look like beautiful horses. Do you mind if I look at them?
Sure, go right ahead, son.
Thank you.
Don't cost nothing to look. Them horses are all hand-carved. Imported from Bavaria. Most people don't notice how special they are. They're the finest in the country.
Morning, Dad.
Good morning, Ellen. Just showing this young man here what fine horses we got.
Oh,
excuse me.
Thanks for watching tonight, Vinyl Tofu. Yeah.
Hello.
Thanks for joining us.
Johnny Drake, how are you?
Dad, have you got the key to the cash box?
Oh, yeah, got them here somewheres.
Oh, thank you.
I better be getting upstairs. I'll see you around.
Again, we're watching Night Tide from 1961, directed by Curtis Harrington.
Well, I'm just going to visit a girl named Maura.
Maura?
Uh-huh.
I ain't never seen you around here before. You, meet her or something?
No. No, I've known her for a while.
Oh.
Well, I'll see you around.
Well, so long, son.
Okay.
Maura, who's played by Linda Lawson. Oh, I love this right here. What a great bit. So, I'm sorry, Linda Lawson. She was known as the Q Girl because she appeared in a Department of Defense film about nuclear explosions for Project Q. Be right back after these messages.
So, why am I here? It's a letter from a colleague in Chicago about a clairvoyant case. Richard, you're going to see the most amazing discovery I've ever made.
Where did you find her? Between the bearded lady and the elephant man?
Professor Austin is a non-believer.
Science and religion often dismiss what they don't understand out of fear and ignorance.
This voyage is the best evidence I've ever come across.
You make an excellent subject. What's happening to us, Richard?
You don't know what you're dealing with.
what happens if you can't find your way back?
Well, then I'd need to find a new body.
Operators are standing by. You're watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Johnny?
Rick Owen One, thanks for joining the show tonight.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Come in.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm pretty good.
Good.
Wow. This is quite a place you got here.
Thank you. I collect things from the ocean.
Yeah, so I see.
Can I take your hat?
Thank you.
Are you hungry?
Yeah, I'm starving.
Good. Breakfast is ready. I have it on the balcony.
Okay. It looks like Olive joined us tonight, too, Rick Owen Juan. Thanks for watching.
Hey, Maura?
Yes?
Sure have a great view.
Thank you. I love it.
Super hot here in Gila Bend. They don't call it the devil's frying pan for nothing. We got a giveaway tonight.
Let's make a toast.
Every caller who calls in will be put into a drawing to win a free dinner at Paestradamus Pizza.
To us, Johnny.
If you call in, we'll put your name in, and we'll announce a winner next week's show. Call in, we'll get you in the drawing.
I found these wonderful fresh mackerel this morning.
Doug, it's always quiet in Gila Bend. It's only when you get out there on Old Benton Highway
where some
weird starts happening.
Especially lobster and crab and sea urchin. Do you ever eat sea urchin?
No, I never have.
It's like a wonderful ocean fruit. You scoop them out like a pomegranate.
I like to taste one sometime.
Oh, they're rare around here, but I think I know where I can get some. Maybe next time?
Okay.
He doesn't look like a seafood fan.
What do you do? I mean, do you work?
I don't think I've ever had sea urchin.
Work.
Final tofu.
In fact, I have you? Today.
On Sunday? What do you do?
When I told you my name, hadn't you ever heard it before?
No, I don't think so.
Well, I work on the amusement pier. I'm an attraction.
What are you, a dancer?
No.
They throw baseballs at you. Don't they? Not really, don't they?
No.
That's what I heard too, Rick.
My
Cohen.
Job isn't dangerous.
They're like the ocean fruit.
I give up. What do you do?
I'm a mermaid.
You're a what?
A mermaid. Half woman, half fish.
I don't get it.
Oh, it's very simple. I wear an artificial fish tail, and I lie in a tank that looks like it's filled with water. And people pay 25 cents
She's
and come
mermaid.
And look at me.
And that's how I make show.
My living.
Don't you ever get tired of it?
Sometimes. But it's restful anyway. I told you about myself. What about you?
Me, I'm a member of the U.S. Navy. You really want to know?
Yes.
Well, my mother...
Dennis Hopper's amazing in this film.
My father, I'm not an actor, my mother and I when I was very young.
But just the things that he does on screen, his little mannerisms.
And I've always wanted to see the world. I never had a chance to. I couldn't. Then my mother fell ill and died. So I figured the easiest way to get out of Denver, Colorado...
That's a later movie Rick Owen won, Tom Hanks. Good movie though, Splash.
Yet.
You will.
I hope so.
Are you going to eat any more?
No.
More's a little strange.
Have food on your plate.
But I mentioned that other woman, that other older woman, played by Marjorie Cameron.
One will come too close.
I'll tell you a little about her later.
They get bolder and bolder.
Well, that'll be a good story there.
Hey. Wow.
I won't hurt you. Surprised you, didn't I?
Where did you ever learn to do something like that?
I don't remember. Probably on the island where I was born.
I don't know if you ever handled a seagull before.
I won't hurt you. Sweet bird, don't be afraid.
I like those.
What poster?
Oh, is that supposed to be you?
Mm-hmm. It's the way I look when I'm in my costume.
If you want to give Hank a call, get yourself in that drawing, you can call now, 520.
I wonder where Sam is.
329-2866.
He's the owner of the show. My boss, as you say.
Hey, aren't you afraid people are going to see you out here?
No. They don't pay any attention to the place until Sam begins to spiel.
Oh, yeah?
Mega Man 1733, thanks for watching. Appreciate it. Yeah, this film was relatively... the very beginning of Dennis Hopper's career.
I beg your pardon. Oh, I was just thinking, my dear.
Yes, I was...
Early.
I was merely contemplating some important matters in the quiet peace of the summer afternoon. Why are you so late?
I'm not late enough to make any difference.
Run along now and get ready, will you?
Oh, I will, but I want to introduce a friend of mine. This is Johnny Drake, Captain Murdoch.
How do you do?
How are you?
Hurry along now. I'll be warming up the amplifier.
All right. I'm going to put my costume on. I'll call you when I'm ready.
Hey, you're not going to be long, are you?
No.
Okay. Whew, sure is a hot day today, isn't it?
Yes, it is, quite.
It's not the skipper.
That right over there must really shake you up. You ever tried it?
No, looking at it all day is enough for me. Tell me, young man. You've been sailing the seas for how long?
Oh, not long at all. I've only gone as far as the Hawaiian Islands. I'm stationed down in Pedro.
Ah, that's a pity. I thought we might reminisce. You know, compare notes as one seaman to another. You know I'm retired from His Majesty's service.
Oh, you mean the English Navy?
Precisely, the English Navy. Later on, I became captain of my own ship. That's how I found her on one of my voyages.
You mean Maura?
Yes, well, perhaps she's told you all about.
No, if you want to get into that drawing, give old Hank a call, 520-329-2866.
You might be interested in that story. It's a very unusual one.
Thanks, everybody, for tuning in tonight.
Now, why don't you come and visit me sometime?
Well, listen, maybe I can come down some weekend when I have liberty.
Yes, no hurry at all. But I tell you what, I'll give you my card. I live in Venice. It's not as grand as its Italian namesake, but it has a certain charm, nevertheless.
Captain Samuel Murdoch.
Yes.
I'm ready, Johnny.
Oh, well.
This is before,
you
I think, Gilligan's Island.
Yes, goodbye.
Bye.
I believe so. This might have been just a good look back in the 60s.
Mora, ladies and gentlemen, Mora the mermaid, the strangest creature in captivity. See her alive. See her living underwater. Half woman, half fish. The strangest creature in captivity for 25 cents, ladies and gentlemen. $0.25. The thrill of your life. Only 25 cents for Mora the mermaid.
What a great shot. I told Big Ed I'd mention it on the air tonight. I always want to ask everybody who's out there driving on Old Benson Highway to keep an eye out. Ida, our canine mascot, she's been getting out a lot. She's addicted to chasing cars. She's always going out to Old Benson Highway. So be careful when you're out there driving. Keep a lookout for her. Crazy thing is, Big Ed's been locking her in his office because she's getting out. But she still gets out anyway. It's crazy. I know how it works, how she does it. But she's got to get out there for some reason. Just asking you to drive careful out there on Old Benson Highway.
Are you going to sleep?
No.
Don't you want to go for a swim?
I'll go a little later. You get cramps if you go in now.
That Ida is a handful. She only got three legs.
It's very, very dangerous to go.
She's amazing. I don't know how she does it.
Maybe.
Hey, Moore, what's with this Sam character?
Sam?
Yeah.
Nothing. What do you mean?
I always heard this growing up, that going into the swimming.
What's his story? After
he get cramps, she drowned. I don't think that's true, though.
You've been thinking about him, haven't you?
Yeah, sort of. Sort of a funny old guy.
He's just a lonely old man.
Do you know him very well?
Quite well. He's my employer. Sometimes I think my only friend.
Again, I'm not an actor, but...
He's your only friend? What about
what Dennis
me?
Hopper does in his scene, this little bits of business. It's really interesting to me.
You don't know me very well. Maybe after you get to know me.
I think I know you pretty well.
On our third meeting? No. But I'd like you to know me better. I'm not afraid of that.
Why should you be afraid?
Tell me, did Sam say anything to you about me?
He said that he found you on some island.
Yes, he did. He found me as an orphan on the island of Mykonos.
Here comes the backstory.
I was just a child, and he adopted me.
You mean he's your,
My guardian. He's been like a father to me. I owe him everything.
I'm sorry, I didn't even realize. If I said anything unkind about him, I'm sorry.
That's all right.
I appreciate you keeping an eye out for Ida out there, Rocky. I do appreciate it.
But he's been so good to me, and I'm grateful. And I know you can understand that because of what you told me about your mother. Would you like some more coffee?
I'd love some.
Yeah, this film, Night Tide, was produced in 1961, Rick Owen. Directed by Curtis Harrington.
You love the sun, don't you?
Yes, the sun.
This was one of his better films.
And the sea.
He worked a lot in television as well, did some movies of the week.
Yes, the sea.
and had quite a career directing episodes of Charlie's Angels and Dynasty.
But I'm afraid of it, too.
I guess we're all a little afraid of what we love. Hey, Maura?
Yes?
Yeah, Mega Man. Dennis Hopper,
you're
great villain in Speed. When we talk about villains, Dennis Hopper in David Lynch's Blue Velvet. Can't top that. Right back after these messages.
Back in the wild frontier, things aren't always as they seem.
God help us all.
A mother with nothing left to lose.
My son and husband were killed.
Must join forces with a town held hostage.
Wiped out half the town. There's nothing we can do.
By a ruthless, supernatural outlaw.
Oh, it's like he ain't even human.
Think of me as a ghost.
But when a mysterious stranger rides into town...
Is that your name? Pelgidian?
A phantom warrior sworn to protect the righteous. They're caught in the showdown between good and evil. Denise Crosby from Star Trek The Next Generation, Angus Scrimm from Phantasm, and Robert McRae in the ultimate dual role.
Well, hello there. At first glance, you failed to recognize me. But you must live a rare life of seclusion. And I pity you for that. For the rest of you, you know this striking visage is none other than I, famed author, noted personality, and the host of television, Unexplained Explained, Walter D. Zart. And I'm here today to talk to you about one thing and one thing only. Pizza. What kind of pizza, you ask? Why, only the best. The most wondrous, the most mysterious pizza out there today. That's right, I am talking about Paistradamus' Pizza Prophecies.
Experience.
You want to get in for that drawing for dinner at Paistradamus, our sponsor tonight. You got to call in tonight and we'll put you in that drawing.
Hey, Maura, you gonna dance for us?
We'll announce the winner next on next week's show. That's right, Rocky. Experience the Zaw. We'll have the phone number up here in just a minute if you want to call in. A little modern dance going on here. Thank you. think you would say that Mora is exotic. Creepy woman saw an opening. Speaking a strange language.
Johnny?
You okay?
Huh? I'm all right.
You just stay there for a minute. It's all right. You okay?
Yes.
Could you get back a little? You okay?
Yes.
It was that woman, wasn't it? Huh?
What woman?
We need you to come down to Gila Bend, Recon. Rick Owen 1, do some of that dancing. We need some rain.
Here's your coffee, Dad.
Thank you.
That mysterious lady was played by Linda Lawson. By Marjorie Cameron.
Hi.
Went by the name just Cameron. She was an actress.
Thank you, my dear.
A poet. An artist.
Well, I was just going out for some coffee.
And an occultist.
Oh, you can have that here. I just had tea, but I
she had a bunch of followers that partaked in sex magic rituals.
Hi there. How are you?
Pretty so they could create a series, a set
That's
of
good.
Moon people.
Sit down, young man.
You should check it out.
Do
a little research on Marjorie Cameron. She was quite an interesting person.
Everyone insisted on using tea bags.
She was married to,
I'd never be able to read anyone's tea
a man by the name of Parson,
so, young man?
Who
yeah, I guess so.
Helped create JPL, and who was a good friend of L. Ron Hubbard.
Fortune tellers never can, you know. They can see for everybody else, but not for themselves. It's quite frustrating.
So if you want to get into our drawing, you can call us now at 520-329-2866. 520-329-2866.
Just a little over a year.
What part of the country are you from?
I'm from Denver, Colorado.
So that actress, Cameron, she was into the call here.
Yeah, I guess you could call me that. I like it out here. When I get out of the
You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Oh, hello. Dad, it's Lieutenant Henderson.
Vinyl Tofu.
How are you?
Where are you calling from?
Would you like a cup of coffee?
No, thank you, I can't.
I'm calling
you haven't seen anything new or unusual.
Wow, Scottsdale. Just north of Heel Bend. What's on your mind tonight, Vinyl Tofu?
It's you, Lieutenant. You come across any new clues?
Why is the film in black and white?
We're not quite sure about it yet, though. There's not very much to go on.
It's nice to know you ain't just given up.
I mean, we had color technology in 1961, but this was a low-budget film
that
was produced for Roger Corman's company, the Film Group, and their business model was just to produce cheap movies that they could put on at the drive-in.
And so
it was just acceptable to shoot it in black and white, which was less expensive, so they could bring the film in on a really small budget.
Why, sure.
But I think it's interesting. Curtis Harrington does a great job in shooting this film, and it's got a great feel to it, I think. And I think it works with the kind of horror, weird aesthetic. What do you think? Are you enjoying the film so far?
Nothing's been proved.
No, not yet.
Did it win any awards?
But don't you think the fact that it's happened twice enough?
It did win some festivals when it first came out, and it pretty much kind of set forth Curtis Harrington's career, allowing him to make other films.
A few days later, their bodies are found.
It's been rediscovered. It was rediscovered in probably in the early 2000s.
Nevertheless, my dear, there wasn't a shred of evidence that it was.
As Curse Harrington got to the end of his career, he was a bit rediscovered himself.
The police haven't been able to make a single arrest.
I know, but if she didn't cause their deaths, then she brings bad luck, and that's almost as bad.
Hey, thanks for calling in, Vinyl Tofu. I really appreciate it. We'll get you into, we'll put you into the drawing, and tune in next week to see if you won that free dinner at Pies for Dummies.
We
want to
ride the merry-go-round.
Sounds great.
Thanks so much. Thanks for calling.
Just hold on. Hey, sailor, it's for you.
That's funny because nobody knows I'm here.
First call of the night.
Hello?
Get Vinyl Tofu into into our drawing. Oh, there's that crazy lady again.
Who was it?
Oh, I don't know.
Interesting.
Look,
I didn't mention on the phone
what
Vinyl Tofu was. This film was pretty successful for Roger Corman's company.
Just a minute, young man.
Film group.
Do drop
he then hired Curse Harrington to make two other films for him using science fiction footage from a Russian movie. And the name of those films were Voyage to a Prehistoric Planet and Queen of Blood. Want to get into that drawing, give us a call, 520-329-2866. Phone lines are open. Curse Harrington was an interesting filmmaker. As a teenager, he was making experimental films. What does that mean? Oh, we got another call. You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Hank. It's Hank.
My name's Hank, too. Where are you calling from, Hank? What's on your mind, Hank?
What's on our mind, Hank?
Who is this? Who's calling? Where are you calling from? Hello? The crank caller or something. Thanks for joining us tonight, anti-postmodernism. You got the greatest handle, I gotta say. This movie does have good architecture. Look at that right there. We talked about this a little bit last week. Surrealism. This film has got a lot of surrealism in it too, and some interesting architecture in here as well. Architecture is a key component in surrealism filmmaking. Ooh, it's the skipper's card. We're watching Night Tide from 1961, starring the amazing Dennis Hopper. That's who that is in that very tight-fitting sailor outfit.
Well, what a jolly surprise. Come in, come in, come in. Well, you finally decided you ought to be with a visitor.
Yes, yes, we were talking about my ward, weren't we? Well, what I have to say is rather difficult to explain, particularly to young people, you know. I feel that young people
sure
nowadays
you do.
Form their
I'm sure you do, anti-postmodernism.
One shouldn't do that. But then perhaps you're different.
What were you going to tell me about Moore?
Oh, my dear, 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 dear. Maybe you aren't different. Patience, young man. Patience is a virtue. You should learn that. But, what I want to tell you is difficult to put into words. Certainly into words that you would understand. However, I can...
You're going to learn some more about Mora.
You are in grave and serious danger as long as you continue to see Mora.
I'm in danger from you?
No, certainly not.
Then what are you talking about?
Mora, my friend, Mora.
You must be crazy.
On the contrary, I'm quite sane. And Mora is quite dangerous to you.
In what way?
Well... shall we say that she suffers from a certain compulsion which might cause her to take your life?
You're trying to tell me that she's
insane? That could make a good movie pitch, postmodernism.
Better if you thought she were. Oh, I wish you'd take my word for it. Break off this acquaintance before it's too late. You're a nice young fellow. I wouldn't like to see you get hurt.
We'll be right back after these messages.
I hear my dad say, Lord, the last time word, I hear my dad say, if I die,
I'm shocked they would let someone like you out. 25 years is not enough.
Lord, I'm a new man, but the new life, I'm not going back.
I want to send my body, send it to my mother-in-law.
The wicked man flees, though no one pursues. Those who forsake the law praise the wicked. Evil men do not understand justice. He who conceals his sin shall not prosper. A man tormented by the guilt of murder will be a fugitive until death. Let no one support him.
Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
I wonder if you'd be good enough to get another bottle of this splendid liquid from the cabinet over there, would you? While you're there, you might turn on the light. It seems to be getting a bit dark in here.
Splendid liquid.
One at the end. On the lower shelf. Well, don't be alarmed. That's just a little Arabian souvenir. The hand of a thief. The Mohammedans punish their thieves by removing the offending portions of the body. Rather gruesome, but logical, don't you think?
How did you ever get that?
It was a gift from the Sultan of Marrakesh.
Guy's quite a decorator.
Things, so he sent it to me. Rather thoughtful of him.
Yeah. That's very interesting.
Another?
You hit that stuff pretty hard, huh?
Well, it may seem that way to your young eyes, but at my age, one needs a little stimulant. You'll find that out later on.
You were going to tell me some more about Mora.
Oh, yes, yes. So I was. Well, you've read the Greek myths, haven't you?
No, I haven't.
You certainly know the legend of the sirens, who in ancient days used to lure seafaring men to their destruction.
Yeah, I've sort of heard of them.
Well, the sirens were a strange race of sea people, half human, half creatures of the sea. The female of the species were known popularly as mermaids. That means women of the sea.
It's like that act you and Moore put on.
Exactly. But that's a fake, isn't it? A sideshow illusion. You wouldn't believe that they actually exist, would you?
No, I wouldn't.
Well, let me tell you, young man, that things happen in this world never dreamt of in your philosophy. Where do you think myths come from? Do you think they're just made up?
No,
they spring from truth. Ancient truth. Living truth.
What does this have
to do with anti-postmodernism? I think he's doing a great job, too. It's realistic.
She was a sweet little thing.
She lived
here with me. Up there. That was her room. Behind that door. I found her on an island. I didn't know then what she was to become.
I've become?
I didn't know then that she belonged to that ancient race. She's a monster.
If you want to get into our drawing, give old Hank a call. Let him know what you think about the film, 520-329-2866.
That's all I can do.
Our studio lines are open.
Look, just tell me one thing. Captain Murdoch, there's a woman that's been bothering Mora. Now, I think she's here. I just want to talk to her, that's all.
Woman? There isn't any woman.
Thanks for the tip, Rick Owen.
Captain Murdoch.
I need some training on my cigar etiquette. Phone lines are open, 520-329-2866. If you want to get registered for that drawing for the free dinner at Paestrodamus Pizza, our sponsor for our show tonight. Mentioned that Curtis Harrington was an experimental filmmaker as a teenager. This location reminds me of another experimental filmmaker, Maya Deren, and her film Meshes in the Afternoon. Architecture looks very similar.
It was right of him to tell you, but I didn't want you to know. Now I suppose I won't see you anymore.
Well, you don't think I believed him, do you?
But it's true, Johnny. They are waiting for me to join them. You've seen one of them.
Take the hand. I think it was stored in.
You saw how she looked at me.
What was that called? Anti-postmodernism? Splendid liquid.
She's one of them. She's one of the sea people, and she's here to remind me of the time that I must go to them in the sea.
He did kind of look like Carl Malden a little bit, didn't he, Doug?
Look, Mara. I don't know how or where you got these ideas, but they're wrong. You see, these things...
Phone lines are open. You want to give Hank a call? 520-329-2866.
Oh, Johnny, if only they didn't. If only they couldn't happen. Americans have such a simple view of the world. They think that everything can be seen and touched and weighed and measured. You think you've discovered reality, but you don't even know.
Americans don't believe in mermaids. They should.
Then you mean that everything Sam told me is the truth?
Almost everything.
Will you just tell me how you know?
Because I feel the sea water.
So Curtis Harrington, as a filmmaker, he not only was a protege, colleague of experimental filmmaker Maya Deren, but he's also a protege and colleague of the famous experimental filmmaker Kenneth Anger, and actually appeared in one of Kenneth Anger's films.
I don't understand.
Forgive me.
J-Bell says she's used to the octopus approach. He's got he's kind of grabby.
Since I was a kid, my grandmother used to have one of these on her dresser. It does sound like the ocean, doesn't it?
When I made the voyage to this country from Greece, I carried such a shell with me over the land.
You can see some of Curtis Harrington's films on YouTube, some of his experimental films when he was a young man.
Johnny, I'm so
afraid. If you have never seen any of Maya Deren's work, you should. And if you've never seen any of Kenneth Anger's work, you should.
Look, I don't know what this is all about.
You love film.
I don't know what it's all about.
You'll enjoy those works.
We'll work this out.
And you could just see some great filmmakers who were inspired by those works as well. She's got all those nets in her room to remember all the men she tried to catch.
Dear.
Yeah, that's right.
I hope you don't mind my telling you, but I will you to come here. I really did, and I'm so happy that it worked.
Oh, really?
I know you have a problem, a very serious problem, and I'm going to try and help you.
She's a fortune teller.
Thank you, I'd appreciate
fortune teller we met earlier at the...
After the reading.
Merry-go-round.
After the reading is time enough to thank me.
How much does a reading cost?
We'll try $32. You can afford that, can't you?
Oh, sure, that's fine.
Have you ever had a tarot reading before?
No, I've never been to a fortune teller before.
Don't use that expression, fortune teller. It's so vulgar. I prefer to be known as a chiromancer or clairvoyant. Now, first we must find the card that represents you.
You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Yes, Toby Bailey.
If you've never had
Toby
a
Toby Daly?
Before,
where are you calling from?
Seen cards that look like these.
Los Angeles.
You're calling from Los Angeles.
Cards is based on these.
How's the weather out there?
Most of the symbolical cards have been left out.
Warren.
Here you are.
I get a hat like you.
The Knight of
Cups. I just went down to the shop, you know, Western wear, and picked it out.
Young man,
it's where I buy all my clothes.
Innocent.
What's on your mind tonight, Toby?
We'll be right back.
Sure,
sure
we will.
All right. Do you have anything featuring
tonight?
No, I am on Big Brother.
Is that a filmmaker?
My little brother Corey's in town.
Are you kidding me, man? That's perfect. Who are you to limit his college experience, huh?
My main man, what's going on?
Chilling, man. I think I picked something up on the fucking booze cruise.
This place is usually bumping at this time.
I hate the week after spring break. Everyone brings back some sort of sick shit with them.
Anybody call the cops yet?
All the lines are busy.
It's pretty safe in here, right? That door is a solidus rock. I said we just stay chill here for a while, right?
Great. Dormers are freaking dead.
We're gonna need a place to go after this, and the studio seems like the safest spot.
You grab something to defend yourselves with. We're moving out.
This is how it always starts. Somebody gets curious. Curious George goes out the door, and then boom!
Here comes the show.
I'm sorry, but when I see somebody hungering for my sweet, succulent brain flesh, I call them a zombie.
College is going to rock!
Experience the song.
A dining experience unlike any other. Players just come to me. I see that they have been rated number one in quality assurance and customer service. At Pystradamus, every employee is handpicked for their psychic ability and mental prowess. Like this young man right here, so he can deliver on our famed motto.
If we forget to predict the toppings on your order before you've made your order, then because we forgot to do that, it's going to be discounted at 50% off of the order. So half off the pizza because I didn't do it right.
Great, and that's a sightseer's guarantee.
Mom!
Experience. You're going to finish that. Watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend.
Toby, we're back. We're back from our commercial. What do you think about this movie?
Contain all the secrets of the universe.
I love the symbol of the
deck of cards contain all the secrets of the universe.
Each card is a symbol.
Not a lot of movies like this.
Linked
anymore.
Together
yeah.
properly.
Do you like this?
All these symbols contain the total of
knowledge. No.
Yeah, it's like putting message in your code.
Exactly.
You know, I find very interesting about this film is the sideshow bit.
What is behind
you? Reminds me of Todd Browning's classic film Freaks, and then of course David Lynch's Elephant Man. There's some similarities here.
Elephant Man was awesome.
What do you say?
I really appreciate you calling in tonight, Toby. We'll put you in the drawing and make sure you tune in next week to see if you won that that free dinner at Paestrodamus, our sponsor.
Tears of the mind. Deep primitive
right. instinct. Thanks for calling. All right.
Okay.
Bye.
You see, the crab is attempting to climb out of the water onto the land, but it almost always sinks back again.
What does that mean?
Don't be impatient. I don't like to make a mistake. Mistake in
this
profession
can be decided. Well, got a lot of calls this evening. I guess people really want to get that free dinner at Paestrodamus.
The card known as the Hanged Man.
What does the Hanged Man mean?
Ah, this is a card of profound significance. The figure shows life in.
I agree, Rick Owen won. This has got great production design.
It's been called a card of martyrdom.
I mean, we're looking, this film's almost 60 years old.
And if you will look closely at the face of the figure, you will see that it expresses deep entrancement. This card shows that a great awakening is possible. And reminds one that after the sacred mystery of death, there is the glorious mystery of resurrection.
She's thinking. She's seeing.
Well, is that good or bad?
My dear boy, the cards don't lend themselves to oversimplification.
Well, what about Maura?
Again, the phone lines are open. Thanks for all the calls this evening. Really appreciate it. 520-329-2866. All our callers tonight will get put in a drawing for the free dinner at Paestrodamus Pizza.
What kind of danger?
Now, that is a question you do not need to ask me. The answer lies already in your heart.
Back at the boardwalk.
Well, I wouldn't put much stock in what a fortune teller says.
I don't. It's just when you keep hearing things over and over again, you start believing it after a while. You said some things about Maura. What do you really know about her?
Oh, I've been sorry about what I said the other afternoon. Well, it was really none of my business. I was just telling you what I'd read in the newspapers, because I thought you ought to know.
I just can't believe that...
Are you in love with her?
Yes.
Funny thing about love, it can happen very suddenly, you know what I mean?
Is she coming on to him?
Like when you're lonely, or when you've been looking for someone.
I don't know what to do for Maura.
He's a caught man.
Believes what, that she killed those boys?
No. I can't explain.
Well, try not to worry about it. Why, maybe things will turn out better than you think. You want some more coffee?
I'm gonna go for a walk. Get some time to kill before Maura gets home.
Is she, working?
Yeah. Well, Ellen. It is Ellen, isn't it?
Uh-huh. I didn't think you'd remember.
He's got to think things through.
Johnny.
His girlfriend could be a murderer. And a fish.
Sometimes when you don't have anybody to talk things over with.
I know. Maybe you'll come around again soon, huh?
Yeah. Okay. I'll see you later.
Okay.
Hanky panky.
Bye, Johnny.
That's a winner, Rick Owen won. That's a winner. We might need some writers for this show. You could be, maybe we should talk. Phone lines are open. You want to get into that drawing? 520-329-2866.
Did you have a good day today?
I sure did. Lots of people on the pier.
That's good. I'm sort of tired.
Why don't you lie down for a while?
Yeah, I think I will. You gonna be in there long?
It's rough being a sailor.
No, not long.
Okay. That's good. I'm anxious to see you.
Racy for 1961. Is a mermaid. I knew it. Ah, there you go, Dame Obsession, Octopus. It's not him, it's her with the hands. Anti-postmodernism. Could you imagine sure. That scene in the modern adaptation with Ryan Gosling? Yeah, I got real Japanese anime for a second there. Oh my, Rocky. The telephone lines are open. 520-329-2866. You can still get entered for that drawing for the free dinner at Paestrodonus' Pizza. Anybody making the connection with the film we watched 2 weeks ago, Carnival of Souls? I don't know. Reminds me a little bit of it. Rick Owen. Mermaids cleanse the sea of toxic masculinity. You're hired. We need you on this show, Rick Owen Warren. I think at the end of Carnival of Souls we saw a scene with a similar location underneath the boardwalk at this pier. Right on, Rocky. calling to her. Right back after these messages.
Where are you? What's going on?
Charlie Regis was killed tonight.
One to the forehead.
You sunk a lot of dough in Charlie's joint. What did you and him fight about?
One of you two killed Charlie. I find out who soon, or I kill you both.
I saw somebody driving away. Could have been anybody.
You've got to help me locate Del before he gets to Charlie.
Whatever I've done for her.
Operators are standing by. You're watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend. Back from 1961, Night Tide, directed by Curtis Harrington, starring Dennis Hopper.
Hi. Good morning.
How are you this morning?
She had a rough night. The sirens were calling her to the sea, back to her domain.
Should I make you breakfast?
No, you stand there. I want you to rest.
I'd like to.
You're live on the air with Hank. What's your name, caller?
Del.
Del from Tulsa. Tulsa, Oklahoma?
Why don't you go have a massage?
Tulsa, Oklahoma? How you doing, Hank?
I'm doing great. That's amazing you can watch our show so far away. What's on your mind tonight?
And, I can pretty much get anything all the way like, up
it's
to Canada.
Down at the end of
wow.
The year.
Well, thanks for tuning in to Amter TV. What do you think of this film so far tonight?
Oh, I think I like it. I do like Dennis Hopper. That's probably why I'm calling. I want to talk to you about Dennis Hopper.
Well,
you like Dennis Hopper?
I love Dennis Hopper. Well, why do you like him?
What would you say your favorite Dennis Hopper film is?
Oh, well, that's it's not a fair question, really. I think our viewers know I have a penchant for David Lynch, and so I'd have to say Blue Velvet. It's a dark and disturbing film.
That's a good film. I constantly like Mario Brothers. Have you seen Mario Brothers?
You know, I have not. Maybe
you
I should.
You haven't seen Mario Brothers.
No.
Is Hopper, Hoskins, Luigi? Because I don't remember who plays Luigi in that movie.
Tied up in
Dennis Hopper's like Koopa.
Question mark. Girlfriend ain't.
He's on Grove Street.
No, it's just.
Oh man, it's fantastic.
I'm just a little tense, that's all. I guess.
Don Leguizamo, I believe it was.
Don Leguizamo?
Well, fancy seeing you.
I want to personally thank you.
What a delightful surprise.
I remember him from some of those old albums.
How are you today, Bruno?
Oh, Captain. You want me to phone you later?
No, my life is called Joe, a pleasure
yeah.
Like that.
Oh, yeah, Carlito's Way.
I hope you haven't forgotten the conversation we had the other day.
I think that's what they call that. But
I'm really worried about you.
Really?
Do you like Dennis Hopper as a filmmaker? I'm a big fan of Easy Rider, but he also made another film I thought was quite fabulous called, I believe it was Into the Blue.
No, I'm not seeing Into the Blue. I have to give it advice.
And be especially careful now at the time of the full moon.
A little bit too much.
That's
hitting.
When the tide is the strongest.
That's my big problem with that. I've noticed big hitting.
As I said,
but
a word to the wise.
Artistry pushed through that prejudice that has some hitting.
Honey, I've been thinking about last night.
But Easy Rider is a chip too high up for me sometimes. You know,
but I must have been walking in
my
sleep.
Do you like, I don't know, is
don't
it Tulsa? Is that, are you a Merle Haggard fan? Like Okey from Muskogee?
You just forget about
John
it. That's what I've been trying to get you to do.
I know.
Don't forget about it.
Right.
So, what are you doing?
Cleaning the bathroom equipment.
I know.
I was looking at the calendar and I noticed that the moon was full. And I realized that the tide will be just perfect at a certain place, I know. And I thought we could go diving there this afternoon.
I'll see him in a while, but I'm almost positive that he's going to
That is cool.
I don't think it's a very good idea.
I think so.
Hey, I think Dennis Hopper's getting a little nervous here in the film.
Mora
wants to go diving with him, and he's like, why? We're going to go out, and he's getting a bit nervous. She wants to go deep sea diving in scuba gear.
I
don't want to rest, Johnny. I feel fine.
We
have such a short time on the weekends, and I have a whole week to rest when you go.
And so I was a bit
please
reticent.
Go with me.
Because, you know, we're from Tulsa. Why would I go scuba diving? Shark water is
what you want to go doing?
Very specific. If I die from a shark being an accident, you start calling on me. So, I didn't go.
Probably a wise move on your part, I imagine.
Well, and then it's what's going on now when you're out of your mind. There's a lot of eerie similarities to what happened to me. But I'm in the Midwest and you're on a boat right now, so it's a little different.
Well, here's a key scene. Maybe we should watch it here and see if it resembles
you
your life at all.
Well,
how do you know where we are?
I'm going to let you go.
Because I've been here before.
We'll get you registered for that free dinner at the Pasta Donald's. Please tune in next week to see if you won.
There are reefs under here.
Thank you for the opportunity, and I'll talk to you soon.
All right, have a great night. Thanks for calling.
Johnny?
Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Stay close to me. We mustn't become separated.
A lot of callers tonight. Phone lines are still open. You still have a chance to win that free dinner at Pastrodama's Pizza. If you call in the studio line 520-329-2866. For 1961, this is pretty amazing here as well, this underwater footage. especially for a low-budget film. I believe I read about the production that Curtis Harrington hired an underwater photographer and just directed him, told him what he wanted, and sent him down. What's she doing? Is she a murderer? Trouble. Kind of interesting. Johnny's character name in this movie, Johnny Drake. Like as in Sir Francis Drake. The Explorer.
Oh God.
Another strange thing is that Curtis Harrington made another movie in his career that involved there was a sailor. His last name was Drake in that film as well. Called The Dead Don't Die. What a horrible situation this is. How long do you wait there? Emo kid on a boat. That's funny. Anti-postmodernism. Mirrors. Mirrors are a common theme or icon in surrealist art. QPR. I like Heineken myself.
Who is it?
Room service, your newspaper.
Just leave him outside.
Now here's back in the day, this is what we call, this was social media right here. For some of you, our younger viewers, this is called a newspaper. This is how we found out things.
Right back after these messages.
Now quit daydreaming about the life you don't have. Get busy living the one you do.
You know, one of these days I'm gonna just go.
You gotta get yourself lost out there?
I need to report a crime. This girl is chained.
And the girl, how's she now?
Ah!
do have money, right?
Cops are looking for a young man that robbed a...
What was it again, Rocky?
Department store. Down around Milltown. Young man, they're looking for fits your description.
Mister, I'm just passing through.
Call me Hart.
You are exactly who I say you are.
Find him. Bring him in.
You are lost to the world, boy.
There's a downside to getting lost.
You become more trouble than you're worth.
Getting foul.
Experience.
Experience. You're gonna finish that song.
Handcrafted to perfection, cooked to pure bliss. With a sauce so savory and sweet, it could only be crafted with a secret recipe as illustrious and mysterious as the company's founder, chef, and esteemed magician, Amadeus von Nostromo. So trust me, New York Post best-selling author, fictional revolutionary, maverick, and all-around handsome man. When you're feeling hungry, pick up that phone and call. But don't be surprised when they tell you what you want to order. And remember, experience the Zaw.
Ice Drama Pizza Brothers 655-7792, corner of Craig Crompton Speedway. Call now and experience the Zaw.
Watching Channel 67, Amter TV, broadcasting live from Gila Bend. That was a great sound cut. Love these shots here too of the park. Thanks for joining us tonight, Psych Films. I love it. You picked this up at a truck stop. DVD copy of this film. Never watched it for $2. I'm glad you got to see it tonight. Still your last chance to get into the drawing for the free dinner at Peistradonis Pizza. All our callers tonight will be put into a drawing and we'll announce the winner next week's show. I love this right here, this scene. The enthusiasm, the energy from the captain here. Great shot.
More of the mermaid, ladies and gentlemen. See her underwater. The only mermaid in captivity. 25 cents.
Love this lighting. disco ball thing. How'd she get there?
I knew you would come back to us eventually. The murderer always returns to the scene of his crime. Oh, I know this isn't the exact spot where the deed occurred, but you had to see her, didn't you? You had to see the result of your monstrous act.
That's right, Rocky. Val Luden quality to it. That's right.
I've loved her ever since she was a child. No, you did it, and you must pay for it.
How did you find her?
God wanted me to find her. She was such a sweet, good child. Why?
I thought the shooting gallery was closed tonight.
It is. It sounded like it came from over there.
Look at this reveal. I love it. What a great shot.
Come in, Johnny. Sit down. This is somewhat irregular, but Captain Murdoch here has agreed to give us a statement, and he asked that you be present. You can go ahead now, Captain Murdoch.
To begin with, I want you to know that no matter what I've done, how wicked or unreasonable it may seem, it was done for love of Maura. I've loved her ever since I found her. She was a pathetic little thing in that Greek island village, abandoned there to almost certain starvation if I hadn't taken her into my home. But of course I realized that, like all children, she would eventually grow up.
That's right. Hopper was a villain in
and leave that home. That
Water World.
On my mind constantly. I couldn't face the thought of her leaving me. So I decided to plan some way to keep her with me always. The best way seemed to make her entirely dependent on my love. In order to do this, I told her the legend of the sea people. Slowly I put into her young and pliable mind the idea that she was one of them. Someday she must rejoin them, and that she couldn't expect to have normal relations with ordinary people. But I never counted on the enormous power of her own independent will. Eventually, my love wasn't enough for her. She had to have another kind of love. And when she began those relationships, I decided the only thing to do was to cut them off at their source. So I killed those two young men. And I tried to persuade her in some way that she had done it, under some strange influence from the sea people. And to a certain extent, I succeeded. I managed to cast a lot of fear and doubt into her mind. But she still demanded her freedom. She left my home, she took an apartment, and then she met Johnny. And if he's
awesome,
told
going
the story,
on.
Then you know the rest. So my experiment in psychology failed. Or perhaps it succeeded too well. She couldn't face the recurrence of what had gone before. So rather than destroy the person she loved, she decided to embrace the rapture of the depths. That's what happened. Isn't it?
Yes.
You loved her, didn't you? Then perhaps you can understand.
So this guy killed those onion men. Brainwashed more.
I do understand.
Captain Murdoch, there's one thing I've been wondering about. Johnny told me about a woman who frightened Maura. She was supposed to be one of these sea people. I assume she was part of your plan.
Woman, I don't know what you mean.
You know, the one that I followed to your house that day. Remember?
I vaguely think you mentioned something about that before, but there wasn't any woman. I don't know what you're talking about. I've told you everything. May I go?
Guard?
But I saw that woman with my own eyes. This wasn't just something out of
classic
low-budget
set.
It's almost as if there was some truth to what she said.
I think it's more likely that Captain Murdoch is merely trying to protect the woman.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Yes?
The shore patrol men are here to pick up Drake, sir.
He'll be right out. Well, good luck, my boy. Just down the hall there.
Hello.
He's a great actor. Dennis Hopper was a great actor.
I found out you were here, so I came
great
down
artist.
To see if there was anything I could do for you.
Thank you.
I'm sorry about Maura.
That's right, Mega Man. Paul Newman, Gene Hackman, Dennis Hopper. Greats.
I hope.
Greats.
Maybe on your next leave, you'll come by and take a ride on the merry-go-round.
I'd like to do that.
Man, this sailor. Got himself another girl now. Yeah, is he AWOL? Shore Patrol came to get him.
What do you know? It stopped raining.
That it has, sir. That it has.
Curtis Harrington was a huge fan of Edgar Allan Poe. When he was a kid, he made a short film, Fall of House of Usher. In his last film, which was never released, he remade the film. So like in the 70s or 80s when he did that. I hope you enjoyed Night Tide with Dennis Hopper. I really appreciate everybody who tuned in this evening. Rocky Psych Films, Rick Owen, Mega Man, Vinyl Tofu. If anybody else I missed, thanks for all the calls that came in. We're offering a new sticker, iWatch Amateur TV. If you want one of these stickers, send us a self-addressed stamped envelope to P.O. Box 15911, Gila Bend, 85060. You want the iWatch Amateur TV sticker? Send us a self-addressed stamped envelope and we'll mail you one. Have a great weekend, everybody. Thanks so much for watching. See you next week.
Our national anthem.